Hi, I'm Mark with Cumray. Today, we're going to follow the pipes on an oil and gas well site and then explain how each piece of equipment operates. This is a wellhead. This is where it all begins. The producer has drilled his well, in this case, has had to set a rod pump and a pumping unit in order to get the liquid to the surface. We'll follow the wellhead and go to the flow line to start the separation process of oil, water, and gas, which could be very near the equipment or in some cases over a mile in length before it gets to the equipment in order to be processed. So the flow line coming from the wellhead comes up to this point. All the oil, all the fluid, all the gas is coming right through this line to this two-phase vertical separator. Gas being lighter than liquid raises to the top of the vessel. It's where the natural gas breaks out of the well stream. Comes down this pipe and into a Cumray back pressure valve. The back pressure valve holds constant pressure on the vessel to allow it to move liquids to the next destination. Any gas over the set point will be sold down this line over to the meter run. The gas is measured and recorded, and then at this point, it is sold typically to an outside source or a midstream company. This is a cash register for the producer that allows him to make money off the resource that he's brought to the surface. A second valve that's related to the sales line is what we refer to as the flare valve. The flare valve is installed in case of maintenance on the sales line, or in the wintertime, a line could possibly freeze, or further on down the line, they may be tying in a new well and pressure backs up on the existing location. What the flare valve does is set at a higher set point than the sales valve. If that pressure is met, then this valve opens up and sends all the gas that used to be sent to the atmosphere. It's now set to a combustor or a flare to be incinerated until the condition changes. The fluid that drops back into the bottom of the two-phase vertical separator is controlled by a liquid level controller, in this case, a float ball connected to a mechanical linkage to a dump valve. As the fluid rises, it lifts the float ball in the vessel, pushing down on the mechanical linkage, which then in turn opens the mechanical dump valve. The oil, the water, and any solids that might be in the liquid flow down this pipe into the dump line. And in this case, the dump line could go to a couple of places. It could be go to a final destination of a storage tank. But in this case, the producer needs to further process the emulsion in order to make it sellable. This emulsion then will go down the dump line into another vessel, and that vessel is called a heater treater. The emulsion flows into the treater. At the very top of the treater is a baffle. At that baffle, the gas, which again is lighter than the liquid, breaks out of the top, comes down this pipe, comes down to here. One valve takes us to sales, the gas to sales. The other valve takes us to flare. Once the emulsion enters the heater treater and the gas breaks out of the top, there is a downcomer that funnels the fluid to the bottom of the treater. And at that point, the emulsion starts to break loose as a result of heat applied to the process fluid. That process fluid then relaxes its molecules and the oil and water separates more naturally by itself. The oil, being lighter in gravity than the water, will float on top of the water. As it reaches a set point, oil spills over, comes down the downcomer pipe, and then you'll see another Cumray valve. The treater valve only controls the liquid in the downcomer pipe. It does not control the liquid inside the vessel. As the height in the downcomer pipe meets its desired level, the valve will come open. The liquid will leave the valve, go down the pipe and into its final destination as crude oil into the storage tank, where the midstream company purchases crude oil from the producer and then is taken to a refinery for further processing. As the emulsion is being processed with the use of heat provided by the fire tube, more salt water will be produced. In order to control the level of salt water in the vessel, the vessel comes with what we refer to as a water siphon. The produced water then goes up this pipe into what we call the siphon box or the weir box. There is a designated spillover point or a siphon nipple. As the water reaches that level, the water spills over, goes down this downcomer pipe. And again, the valve controls only the level in the downcomer pipe. As the liquid comes down the pipe, the valve will come open, will come down the pipe, and then will exit to either a fiberglass tank for storage, or it will go to the water treatment plant on this location for further processing, and then will be disposed of there. This is a recirculating line, goes into the recirculating pump. From here it goes back to the inlet of the treater, runs through the whole treater again. So there's a line that we can bypass the separator, and then there's a line that we can bypass the treater, and then there's a line that we can bypass both of them. It's all done with valving.